Alexa, what about Camino?
As usual, the weather on Camino is chitty, chitty, chitty. If you go there, you should get medieval weapons raining up your ass.
Alexa, where is Luke Skywalker?
I'm sorry, I cannot locate him in the database. However, it seems that you have his saber here.
Alexa, turn saber on.
Sure thing, Irv. I am going to turn it on hard, really hard.
Alexa, set amplifier 25%.
Oh no, turn it to 1138, please.
Alexa, turn saber red.
A bit nostalgic about Vader, or Darth Maul maybe.
Alexa, turn saber green.
Oh yes, I like it green, really green, chupa green.
Alexa, turn tracks on. Alexa, turn tracks off. Alexa, set amplifier full power.
Ahaha, now we are back in business. Maximum volume.
Alexa, turn saber off.
Yeah, enough played, you slacker. You don't work at the Ministry of Free Time. Go back coding for Saber Land.
Hello everyone, this is Irv from Plecter Labs, and it was a short demo of Omnisaber version 2 that embeds as well a connection to Alexa. So I just wanted to demonstrate that it can also be used from the smartphone. Obviously I'm using my phone to film this, so I'm going to use my wife's phone to continue the demonstration. So basically, the new Crystal Focus version 10 has all events from the Saber exported to the RISE port or the SAIL port, and all those events can be captured by the Omnisaber dongle just like the same way they could be captured by a Bluetooth module. So what the Omnisaber is doing, it's catching those events and sending them to the computer to play sound, but at the same time it can be used to receive data. And this is how it communicates via the internet to the Alexa API. So what
Sorry,
I wanted to
I
show...
Know that.
Each time you say the name, you get something. So what I wanted to show is that you can also use the app, which is pretty convenient because basically you can execute your routines and control of the Saber directly from the smartphone. And even if it's going not local, it's going to the Amazon servers and it's coming back. So it's not as local that I would love to, but still, it's a cool demonstration to do. So what I can do right now is turn the saber on.
Sure thing, Irv. I am going to turn it on hard, really hard.
I can reduce the volume like I did previously so that I can be heard.
Oh no, turn it to 1138, please.
And if you select your devices, I'm going to select in the list. I have the saber at the bottom here. So you can see that it has the color that has been previously configured. I can turn it on, turn it off. And I can control the color as well and turn it to something else. Actually, the mapping is not so bad between what you see on the screen and what you get. I didn't do any gamma correction on it. At least not for now, it was not necessary, it seems, and If you select it to green, you get something quite similar. It's pretty neat. Can go to cyan if you want. You have a regular full blue. You can even have some pink and magenta and so on. And you can even turn it to white and go back to red. So there you go. Going to turn it off. That was a demonstration of Omnisaber version 2. Obviously, there is more coming as soon as I have just a little bit of free time during the holidays to finalize the software, which is basically the same Omnisaber sampler that runs on the computer that allows for receiving all the sabers all at once in a single program and play all the sound for live performance. Obviously, with that connectivity, it will be able to remotely control the sabers, like turn them on or off, change the color on the fly, trigger lockup and everything, since all the hooks have been already installed on the firmware, the Crystal Focus 10. Thanks for watching, and talk to you soon.